paddling technique. The canoe advances through the water by means of impulses or strokes transmitted by the canoeist in a cyclic continuous motion. The length, force and duration of each stroke is determined by the speed we require for a given situation or competition. Thus, we can see that the shorter the distance of the competition, the greater the number of strokes per minute. This frequency increases in C2 compared to C1. There are also variations during the course of a race. In resistance races, the rhythm is slower, although there can be abrupt changes during the race, depending on the tactics used. Apart from the rate of strokes, the canoeist looks for two basic things in each stroke: a good loading point, so as then to be able to propel himself forwards efficiently. All this without losing his balance. If a canoeist copies a particular style, he should allow for some variations, so as not to hamper his own personal qualities. We shall look at the different parts of a stroke: the entry, the catch phase, the exit, and the air transfer. Entry is the moment the paddle enters the water. To do this, the canoeist moves his whole body forwards towards the water, so that the stroke gains amplitude and inertia. The hips and legs move, accompanying the movement. The torso flexes forwards and forms a continuous line with the thigh of the kneeling leg, and it rotates approximately 30 degrees. The pulling arm is horizontal, and the steering arm is over the head. The paddle then has an angle of approximately 45 degrees. In this movement forwards and towards the water, the canoeist has to keep his hips orientated to stern. Looking from behind, if we imagine a line joining the canoeist's side and his thigh, this should tend to be straight. The correct positioning of the different parts of the body at this stage will determine the success of the following stages. On entry, the canoeist uses the weight of his body. The torso bends towards the water. The paddle is vertical, and the hips should maintain their position. The arms descend slightly. The main difficulty in this phase, either during the air transfer or catch phase, is in maintaining good control of the hips when the canoeist transfers his weight out of the canoe. The heel fixture is very important at this stage. The most common errors on entry are various: lack of torso rotation, pushing downwards, excessive hip movement, or wrong paddle angles, etc. The catch phase describes the movement of the paddle in the water. It is the driving force, and it is the most complex part. Taking the canoe as a reference, the paddle follows a curve from the moment of entry. In each moment of the catch phase, the paddle has a different angle to the water and a different efficiency. The most efficient position is when the paddle is 90 degrees to the water. Rest of the positions give different results. Yet, while they also help to drive the canoe forwards, they are at the same time responsible for part of the movements which cause the bow to pitch and heave. The distribution of force during the catch phase is also important. Some canoeists have a strong increase in force during the first third of the catch phase, thanks to a strong attack on entry. Then the force diminishes progressively. Other canoeists distribute the force more evenly. The increase is less, but it is maintained for a longer period. In the first case, the paddle sinks earlier and its course is more circular. In the second case, the course is longer and less curved. But in both cases, the stroke is effective for these canoeists, who are both of a similar competitive level. Looking from behind, the paddle works perpendicular to the water, following a line which is almost parallel with the canoe. The canoeist's performance during the catch phase is clean and without loss of inertia. From the moment of entry, the shoulders rotate, the hips go back slightly, and they also rotate towards the offside. The legs transmit the impulse by pushing backwards. The torso rises in a continuous movement. The arms maintain the position of the paddle, but they have no initiative during the catch phase. The steering arm descends as the torso rises. Just before the exit, the hips begin to rotate towards the paddling side, and the body moves forward. It's a difficult movement, but it helps the exit and the entry, and it partly eliminates the negative effects caused by the forward movement of the body during the air transfer. During the resistance stroke, the amplitude, the force, and speed are never the same as in a speed stroke. Overall, in this part, once the canoeist has placed the paddle in the water, he impulses himself by rising and moving backwards, at the same time transmitting the impulse through his resting knee and his forward foot. In the last part of the phase, the canoeist advances, still with the paddle in the water, positioning himself in time for the next stroke. The errors in this phase, besides those which arise from incorrect entry or position, are mainly a loss of inertia as the stroke slows down. and bad working angles in the water. Excessive hip movement, sideways or backwards. A lack of balance of the canoe or the canoeist.